What even is it anyway?
Well, it's like a multi-faith session, isn't it? So like they're going to teach us about their faith.
Well, James and Errol said that they're going to try and turn us all into Muslims.
Oh, don't be daft. It's not about that.
Isn't it?
No, it's like, it's about learning what they do in here and in like the community, I think.
So they're not going to try and recruit us into that Oasis thing?
Oasis? No, they're not. And it's not Oasis, it's ISIS. Don't you listen to what Mr. Latham says in class?
No, but I listen to my dad, and my dad says he's not happy about me coming here. And James and Neville said they're not even coming.
Oh, don't listen to them. They don't think before they speak, eh? And besides, if James weren't coming, how come he's here now?
Hello, girls.
Yeah. Where's Errol?
He's not coming, is he?
We thought you weren't coming.
Yeah, well, I weren't coming, was I? But can't have any more days off school.
Why weren't you going to come?
Because I'm not a Muslim.
Oh, neither am I, but it doesn't matter.
It does.
It doesn't. Does it, Louise? I don't know.
Why would you go to a mosque if you weren't a Muslim?
Well, I've been to like loads of churches for parties.
Churches for parties? Like proper parties?
Yeah, you know, like christenings and weddings and that. And I don't believe in God.
Well, I don't know why you're sticking up for them anyway, them Muslims. You probably won't even be allowed to speak when we get in there.
Why not?
My dad said that they don't let the women speak, and they can't even get jobs or anything.
That's proper sly, that.
I know. And most of them can't even go to school, so I'm going to ask them when we get in there, hey, why do you treat the women like that?
Well, my dad hits my mum, and he's not a Muslim.
Exactly. See, don't know what you're talking about, James. Everyone's the same no matter what religion you are. Mr. Latham says so.
Oh, look, we'll have to go, because that woman's opening the door who's running the workshop.
Woman? There's a woman in the mosque?
Yeah.
See? Got the stun.
Got the stun. Okay. And there's more. That's a cover.
His attitude's coming in. Prejudice. And prejudice comes from prejudging, isn't it? What prejudgments were they making?
They're going to turn us all into Muslims.
Again, what were the misconceptions about women? And I was really interested, where did those misconceptions come from?
Parents.
And I think one of the things that Catherine and Natasha shared was so often, it's my dad told me to ask this, or my uncle told me, my mum told me to ask this. So young people are coming in armed with questions that their parents want the answer to, they don't necessarily. Did you get a sense of that? What else did you get from the three young people? Did they all have the same attitude?
No, we got one from different areas. One who was probably neutral, one who was against, and one who was positive.
Yeah, and again, I think, yes, Catherine?
Like one's very eager to learn, yes. Very open, and you know, the others were quite blinkered,
weren't they? And I think that's something that's certainly what we picked up. There's some come in with a readiness and a hunger and a passion to learn about the mosque. Some people come in not quite knowing why they're there, and some come quite reluctantly. Because they can't afford to miss another day of school. But whatever the reasons, they're welcomed with an open heart and an open mind. And what I got the sense of was that how ready the team are and the education team to kind of meet and greet young people's questions wherever they are on that journey. Any other observations about the young people there? No? Okay. Well,
it's a generational thing.
Right, hold on to that. It's a generational thing, because something quite interesting happened in terms of this. But are we picking up that Dad certainly is hostile and hasn't opened his heart up? So we're going to take you through kind of the next stage, the rushing out. Can you see why they got young people's fares on the way? I hope they were honourable and actually paid the full fare. Yeah. Got a civic. All right. So one of the things we wanted to tap into was what learning did take place, and this is just bringing to life the students' experience, the pupils' experience further on their visit.
I've never been to a mosque before, so I was really excited to learn about the religion and the community.
And I've never been to a mosque before, but I didn't really know what to think because you hear all that bad stuff on the news, don't you?
I've never been to a mosque before and I'm never going to a mosque again, right? He made us take our shoes off when we went in and I just got a brand new pair of 110s for my birthday and I wanted to show them to the girls. And then, when we got in there, my socks had holes in them.
Oh, shame! The shame of it. Well, I didn't really know what to think about it, but I was actually glad that they made us take our shoes off because they had these gorgeous marble staircase and all these lovely carpets with all boss patterns on.
Yeah, it reminds me of my nan's a bit because she makes everyone take their shoes off before they go into her house. And she got like a plaster cover over the couch as well. And she had that couch since I was a baby.
When we got in there, Catherine, the woman who was running the workshop, she sat us all down and she started to tell us about the mosque and why it's important for the people in the community. And they had this big telly on the screen and you could see all the people coming and going downstairs. And there was like loads of old people as well. And they all come and go all day, Catherine said. And she said, they even leave the glasses and the tablets there. And that reminded me of my granddad, actually, because, you know, my granddad, he goes to the Legion all day to play cards with his mates, right? And my mum says, he might as well live there.
I was a bit uneasy about the big TV in the room, right? Because when we were watching it, there was a fella downstairs with one of the proper big beards that they have, like the ones that you see on the news. So I was like, hey, what's he up to there? And then I was watching him, and then he sort of, like, disappeared off the screen. So I was wondering what he was up to. And then whilst Catherine was talking, I just kept waiting for the bit when I could ask my question that my dad told me to ask about why they treat the women like second-class citizens.
Then Catherine told us the similarities between the main religions.
Yeah, because they have this thing called a dawn, and yeah, it's like a call to prayer. And she said that it's like the church bells. So Muslims just use the voices instead.
And showed us this video about the pilgrimage to Mecca, and it was like proper fascinating because you could see loads of people from all over the world gathered in one spot.
It's a bit like Anfield on a match day, that, isn't it?
Do you know, I still wasn't sure about it at first, but then when she started talking about what connects us and about the similarities in the religions, and did you know this? That they have the same God as Christians have. Well, when she said that, I thought, I get it now.
The thing that was a bit weird for me, right, was, you know, on the video about that pilgrimage to Mecca thing, right, I was watching it, and there was a white lady in, like, the full robe thing that they wear.
The burqa.
Yeah, that's it. And I've never seen a white person being Muslim before, so I thought I'll ask that, as well as my question about the women being slaves, right? So I put my hand up, and I went to Catherine, why is that white woman pretending to be a Muslim? And Catherine Wright said that the white lady was a Muslim and that Muslims can be from like any race. I thought that was mad, mate. But, you know, so then I said, well, what about the women? No, I said, if she's a Muslim and she's white, can you have white Muslims in England? And then this lady put her hand up in the back and said, yeah, me. Felt a bit sly then, but you know, she weren't wearing a burqa or anything like that, so she probably blended in. Like, I weren't meant to know, was I?
Then James asked us other question, didn't you?
Yeah, well, I said, well, why aren't the women equal? And she said that they are, and the only reason that they play in different rooms was to stop like people getting distracted and that.
Yeah, like you were distracting us with your holy socks.
Oh my god, shut up. And then she said that they can have an education and stuff, and if they couldn't, how would she be able to run this workshop for us?
Yeah, and then he went proper red, got proper ashamed, because then he realised he'd been getting it all wrong.
I still wasn't completely sure, to be honest. Like, my dad reckons half of them can't even go to school.
Then Catherine said that we could wander around the room and have a look at all these cool posters and Islamic things, and we had to find our favourite fact and bring it back at the end.
Yeah, and whilst we were looking at the posters, there was this other room and you could go in and film this thing called the ARM News.
Yeah. We thought it'd be dead good and it'd be a really good opportunity because all you see on the news about Muslims is really negative stuff. So now it'd be our chance to do something positive.
And we got to be on the telly. Yeah, I'm
not. Yeah, it was proper boss. I proper buzzed off at me. Like, being on the news, like, not the Muslims or anything, you know, I still wasn't sure about that. I was just thinking, like, what's my dad going to think when I get in?
Okay, if you just stay there, we'll stay there between. Okay, what are you hearing? What impact is the visit having on them already?
Changing views.
Do we get a sense that hearts and minds are opening up? Anything else?
There's a contrast between the girls and the lads.
So no gender, that's not a gender bias. It's how it happened. Yeah, no.
What's the difference between the lads and the girls? Although Louise here has come on quite a journey. She was the one, wasn't she, that didn't know why she was there. Yeah? Anything else?
They're admitting their doubts, weren't they? The lad was admitting his doubts at the beginning, so the doubt wasn't right.
Yeah. And that was really exciting because, you know, I think the education team want people to come in questioning. They want people to come in and feel free enough to share those. Any other thoughts? Well, as you can see, this really, really did engage them. And I have to say, before I came to the mosque, Natasha and Catherine sent us some ARM from other schools, and it really did capture my imagination, and we asked our team to kind of to do it on the day too, so that exists on the ARM.
Welcome to ARM News. I'm Katie.
I'm Louise.
And I'm Trevor McDonald.
James.
All right. I'm James.
Today was very interesting as we learned about the religion and culture at the mosque.
Yes, Katie, thank you.
Yes, and we learned how similar Islam is to Christianity. They all have the same God, you know.
Yes, and we learned about the five pillars of Islam.
My favourite fact of the day was that one of the pillars, the Muslims have to give a certain percentage of their money to charity. I think that is very good. And we learned how Muslims fast during the month of Ramadan and they can't eat pork all year round.
Not even bacon?
Oh, weren't you listening? No pork, no gambling, no drinking alcohol.
Oh yeah.
We also learned James needs new socks.
Oh my God, shut up.
Yes, and we have loved our time at the mosque and we would very much like to come back again. What an experience.
Yes, we found the atmosphere and the people lovely. Thanks for tuning in. See you next time on
A.M.
News.
James?
James, how are you going to challenge your dad now?
Well, what I'll do, I'll just say, no, because there was a woman there, right? And she was talking, for one. And she was talking about stuff, for two. So she knew stuff, so she was educated, and she was allowed in there. So he's wrong, isn't he?
Do you think you three were typical of people of your age? Or were you putting it on? Were you exaggerating it?
No, it was a strange experience for me though to be going in there. So, I mean, I weren't acting like I would act in school and stuff like that because there's different people there and that. But, I mean, I know a few people who think like me, but, like, there's more girls in our school than they, and it's not like, because I heard someone say before, is it like a gender thing? Like, some girls think like me and that as well, but, like, most of the people I think are pretty much all right with it. But, you know, it's like, it depends who you talk to, don't it? Like, my dad and his mates and that say, don't listen to the news, because the news is full of lies and that. So, you can't listen to it, can you?
Katie, you were quite excited about coming to the mosque, yeah?
Yeah, I was really excited. I don't, like, believe in God's name like that. I'm just really interested in all different religions, because it is, like, a really interesting topic when you think about it. And it's exciting to learn about new things, and plus it's a day off school as well, coming to the mosque, isn't it? So.
Can I ask what all three of you, what do you actually think about the media, how they do portray it? You've just done the news early, you're all wet. How do you think that will move you?
It's always bad, isn't it? Like, when you see the news or like the papers and stuff like that, it's always negative stuff about Muslims. So, like, you do have that, you do, like, when we were in school and, like, Mr. Latham, our RE teacher, he, like, tells us about all the different religions and that. And, like, it's just, like, he says we're all the same no matter what religion we are. And it's true, isn't it? Because we are all the same. So, I think the media just like to pin people into something, to be honest with you.
You were quite surprised when news about there being a mosque here in Liverpool. You thought you were going to have to travel.
Yeah, I thought that we were going somewhere far away, but I didn't know. It was like literally round the corner.
Yeah.
I said, because it's the oldest one as well, isn't it?
That's what they said.
It's the oldest one in England.
In England,
isn't it?
Yeah, I think.
Really good, that.
Any other questions? All right, but it didn't end there. And what we were able to do was just tap in. There was quite something happened that was quite profound, wasn't it? So our final input is just to share with you what the impact that it genuinely did have upon the lives of one of the young people particularly.
It's been a few months now since we went to the mosque.
Yeah, me and Lou haven't been back yet, but you have, haven't you, James?
Yeah, I didn't think I would, to be honest.
Tell them what happened.
When I went home, I tried telling my dad, like I was talking to you about before, like, ah, no, because there was a woman there and stuff, but my dad said that it was all propaganda and I shouldn't listen to it and that he was right.
Yeah, but tell them what happened then.
My granddad's proper ill, right, and since my nan died, he just sort of sits on his own in the house, and then he fell over on the ice, and my dad said, it's really bad and really serious. Because he's dead old, my granddad, he's like 65 or something, right? So we had to go and see him in hospital, and he broke all these bones in his legs and that, and like fractured his cheek. So he was in there for weeks. So I'd go in and see him and stuff like that.
Yeah, but tell them what happened like when he was in there and that.
Oh, well, when I went in to see him, he proper perked up after a little bit, because I used to go and see him every day after school, you know, because you've got to be nice to your granddad and that. 65, he's not going to be here forever, like. And so I went in and he proper perked up, and he said that he had a new mate in there who was a doctor, but his mate was like a Muslim doctor, right? And he said that they used to talk together loads while he was there and talk about the cricket and that. My granddad's proper into the cricket, right? Like, if you want to know anything about anyone, like all the old-fashioned names you've never even heard of, my granddad's got like little cards of them and everything, right? He knows everything. My dad reckons that that's the reason he stayed in the hospital, right? Because he had a mate to talk to about the cricket, and because we don't talk about cricket, we talk about football and that and that.
So what happened when your granddad was getting better?
Oh yeah, well, I went in to see him, right? To pick him up, because the doctor said that he could come home now. He said that his legs are sound and that, and he can walk on them. And so we could come home, so we went in to get him, and he was exchanging numbers with the doctor fella, you know, the Muslim doctor, before he was leaving. I didn't even know my granddad knew how to use WhatsApp or anything, right? And so we was exchanging numbers, and as I got a bit closer, I noticed that not only was the doctor a Muslim doctor, it was the fella with the beard, you know, from the telly camera who I'd seen downstairs. I felt proper sliding, like, about the way that I'd been in the mosque and the way that I was thinking and that, so I went over and I shook his hand and said thanks for being nice to my granddad, and because I know that's what my granddad would have wanted me to do, right?
And then what happened?
Believe it or not, I've been back here a couple of times, like not like coming in to pray or anything like that, but my granddad comes in to see his friend and they just talk about cricket or whatever, and I walk him down, you know, because he's still a little bit unsteady on his feet. So yeah, I come down and see him.
So is your dad sound about it all, man?
No, he's still fuming. But funny thing is, he still has to drop me and my granddad off because he's got his car on my granddad's mobility. So he still has to drop. He won't come outside the mosque though. Like he just waits at the top of the street. So that's why I walk him down.
What did your granddad think about that?
Oh, he said my dad's a stubborn old get.
That where you get it from then?
No, I'm not stubborn.
Yeah, just stupid.
Look, I know I didn't want to go to the mosque in that in the first place, but to be honest, I'm glad that I did. You know, like, I've spoke to my granddad about all the stuff that I learned here and stuff like that, and he speaks to his friend about it. And last time we were here, right, when my granddad came in, we showed him the video that we'd done at the ARM News, and he reckoned that it was boss.
Yeah? And could you see your only sock on it?
Oh my God.
Thank you.